Modern animism is an everyday type of spirituality where your beliefs show up in what you do, and creating connection is one of our paths to animism here at Pan Society. Other awareness is critical to that, and today I'm going to talk about 10 ways to bring other awareness into your everyday animism practice. Stay tuned. Hi, I'm Laura Giles. Welcome to our channel. If you dig the message, please practice reciprocity and like, share, subscribe, or comment to let us know what touched you, positive or negative. Thanks. Before I talk about those 10 other awareness tips, let me share what other awareness is. Other awareness is knowing that others exist and thinking about how your actions impact them. So it's empathy. And empathy is a component of emotional intelligence. Without emotional intelligence, we don't have meaningful relationships. And animism is all about relationships. It's like there is poison ivy and honeysuckle. I stay clear of poison ivy because getting too close could be unpleasant. I know its nature, and I'm aware of how to interact with it. Honeysuckle is a different thing. It smells nice, it looks pretty, and it's pleasant to be around, so I lean in and get close. And the more people have to adjust to you and be aware of you, the more they stay away. And the easier you are to be around, the more they lean in and welcome a relationship with you. All right, so let's look at those 10 ways to bring other awareness into your life. Number 10, respect the clock. If you're hosting an event, make the start and end time clear. If you're a guest, don't overstay your welcome. Don't assume that because things have been free and easy, that it's okay to stay longer than that stated end time. People may have agreements with babysitters or other commitments that you don't know about. We don't know what is going on in other people's lives, so only take up as much time as was offered. When I was a kid, I babysat for two mothers who never returned on time. So this is a pet peeve of mine. Number 9, respect boundaries. Even if someone doesn't have a no trespassing sign up, don't cross into someone else's space without permission. It's not only rude, it's illegal and may be dangerous. I was looking at going to this waterfall that is supposed to be absolutely spectacular, but everywhere it says that access is blocked because it's private property. And if you go there, you risk a gigantic fine, it's like $5,000, I think, or being killed by a train because there's not enough clearance if you get caught in the wrong place at the wrong time. And people can't hear the train over the roar of the waterfall. But guess what? There's all kinds of reviews and pictures of big crowds at this place, even people with their kids. And that's bad juju, y'all. Boundaries aren't about whether or not you like them, or they're convenient, or if they're fair. We live by boundaries because they make our relationships better. Number 8, no means no. If you're told not to do something, don't do it. This means eating something that was not intended for you, smoking in a no smoking area, not wearing a mask in a mask zone, or not walking across someone's lawn. Again, you don't have to like it or agree with the rules. The person who's in charge of an area gets to make the rules. And if you don't like it, you don't have to be in that space. But if you are in that space, obey the house rules. Number 7 is learn how to merge. Have you seen all the people on the freeway who don't know how to merge? I know you have. Merging is about the slower person moving into the flow of traffic in a way that doesn't impede the flow of traffic. It's not complicated, but just today, someone pulled out in front of me going 40 miles an hour on the freeway. So sharing the planet with others means that you have to have other awareness. Everybody has needs and has a right to be here, but when we do it in a way that has minimal impact on others and causes no problems, it's easier for everybody. And merging is an easy one. We can all learn how to do that well. Number 6 is give as much as you take. Practice reciprocity. The whole planet gives every single day. The sun shines so that we have warmth and things can grow. Rivers flow and bring us all water. The earth nourishes plants and animals that become our food. So what are you giving? Everything has a carrying capacity. If you aren't returning something into the mix, it dries up. So be a good neighbor and give back. Number 5 is share space well. For example, I hike almost every day, and I can't tell you how many times I've almost gotten run over by cyclists. They seem to have no other awareness. This even happened today. So I know I often say take up space and we should all be seen. That said, we also have to be aware of how much space we can occupy without encroaching on others' comfort and well-being. We should also be aware of how we use that space. So I shouldn't have to move out of the way to be safe. And if I do, you're either too close or too aggressive. Number 4 is be sweet-tempered. It costs you nothing and beautifies the energy more than anything. Number 3 is control your animals and your kids. Your animals and your kids are your responsibility. And again, I was on the trail. I had a couple in front of me who had a dog on a leash that was barking aggressively and kept running up behind me and then slowing down, then running up and slowing down. And I finally realized that the dog had no training. You kind of tell because the leash was just way too long. And I moved over and I just waited for them to walk past because it was just, there was nobody in control here. And I didn't know what the dog might do. So when you're in a public shared space, just be aware of what's going on. It should be welcoming and safe for everybody. Number 2 is clean up after yourself. I don't have to explain that one, do I? I hate trail litter. I see it every day. The planet is everybody's responsibility, so let's keep it clean. This goes for shared living space too. Nobody should have to clean up after you. Number 1, if you can't say something nice, consider silence. Now, sometimes it is better to speak up because it teaches someone something or saves them from grief. But most of the time, criticism or judgment just doesn't need to be shared, does it? So unless it's asked for, consider keeping that to yourself. I know this list could go on and on. What other awareness tips would you add? Let me know in the comments. And if you'd like more like this to help you build your animus practice and get connected, come see our online animus class. Ciao, guys.